The state of arts and education in New York City was terrible, frankly, because in many ways it had totally shut off in the 70s when the city went bankrupt.
They made a terrible mistake and they removed art from the curriculum in our public schools, feeling that it saved money. In fact, it was penny wise and pound foolish.
And many of us feel that the most important thing for the future is to teach kids about the arts. So much comes from their knowledge of the arts, from their performing, from their working with the arts, for the things they do in the arts. And Annenberg, of course, being a great man, I mean, Walter actually felt that this was the thing of primary importance in the country, or one of them.
Just look around, how many schools have reintroduced arts? How many parents have taken it for granted? How many children, because of arts education, have not dropped out of school?
I did an internship with Alvin Ailey Dance Foundation through CAE's Career Development Program. Living in New York means that you're bombarded by art everywhere. Every step that you take, you're surrounded by art. But just because we're surrounded by art doesn't mean we're a part of it. That's why I'm thankful that we really do have this program, because it really, really did just open that door for us and said, here, we're going to give you the tools that you need to work in these places. Now show them what you got. This program really, it really helps you grow up. And it really just teaches you what it's like to be an adult, what it's like to have responsibilities, and what it's like to have other people respect you.
We're on the A string. We're playing 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
As for myself, in school, they didn't have like band or instrument playing. So this was my really first experience with it. And it's a thrill because you're able to do it with your child.
Okay, and I'll count you in. 1, 2, 3.
I like doing it with my dad. It makes it more fun.
Yeah, I love doing it with him. It's definitely a great thing to do with your child. It gives you a bond, and you know, you'll think of it years from now, you know, about this moment.
I think the thing that's been phenomenal about the Center for Arts Education and what the Annenberg Foundation has done is they've opened up the doors of all these great institutions. And they've created this opportunity for places like Lincoln Center, for places like the Metropolitan Opera, for places like MoMA to go out into public schools. And until the Center for Arts Education came around, until the Annenberg Foundation decided, I want to make the arts a critical part of education. Whether a kid made his way down to a museum or not, or whether a kid made his or her way down to see a play or to go listen to a piece of music, it was totally dependent on whether or not the principal or the parents were interested in that experience. But all of a sudden, you've got this partnership piece that begins to evolve out of the Center for Arts Education, where cultural institutions have to partner with schools.
To your spot. How many? Let's figure out some times. You like four twirls? That's a good idea. One, two, beautiful. Three, four, tumble. Five, six, seven, eight. Start your circle. Wait.
I'm Maria Mitchell. I'm a teaching artist, dancer, and choreographer, and I love my work.
Wow, give yourself a hand. That was gorgeous.
I was fortunate enough to be included in the first round of Annenberg grants. To have funding come into the schools that offers an opportunity for children to actually have contact with real artists and to really dig into the process of making art and connecting that process to their schoolwork, there's a common link, and that common link is the discipline and the focus of being an artist.
What a nice trio. I love the leaves blowing in the wind. Look at that.
The classroom size is about 30 children per class. I see up to 5 classes a day, 2 days a week, sometimes 3 days a week. I see 1,000 kids a year easily.
Kids in this neighborhood see a lot of crime, there's a lot of poverty, there's gang activity. And if you ask children to write, that's what they would write about. They never had positive things to write about. I first started in the school under very difficult circumstances, and it was the bottom of the barrel in terms of all of the schools in the district. I came in and said, something has to be done here. So I said, you know what? I need to bring something to this school that children have never had. Therefore, the arts. You know, I was born and raised in this very community, okay? So for me, it's a very personal journey because everything that I bring, that I brought to this school, I brought to my community. And the notion that children from this community should not have arts education is personally insulting to me because if I had not been given the opportunities that I was given as a child from this poor community, I would not be in the position that I am now.
Boys and girls, we've studied many different artists, and I want you to tell me who your favorite artist was. Let's see. Rihanna.
Our favorite artist was Jackson Pollock, because when he was splattering, he used a lot of colors and light colors and warm colors.
Reading and math have gone off the charts. We've had growth year after year after year. We thank the Annenberg Foundation and certainly the Center for Arts Education for picking us. They took a leap of faith in a school that was a low-achieving school at the time in a very poor community and said, okay, we're going to see. And certainly this school has become a model for arts education, not only in the city, but throughout the country. So they've done a wonderful thing for us. And in return, I think we've done a wonderful thing as an example of what can happen when you really infuse arts education in everything you do in a school.
Something like the arts and arts program in public school is a fundamental part of our democracy. I mean, the idea that there can be kids that have and other kids that don't have goes against the very principles that this country was founded on. To put in perspective just how things are with arts teachers is for a drama teacher, there's one for every 7,000 students in the public school system. Music teachers, one for every 1,200 students in the system. There are hundreds and thousands of kids that whose only meaningful contact with the arts is gonna be some overextended arts teacher pushing a cart with a couple of paintbrushes and a jar of paint and exposure to that once a week for 45 minutes. And it's unacceptable. It's simply unacceptable.